You walk into a room with a lot of strange faces, but once we were all introduced to each other, we were all looking forward to having a good time, and that combined expectation created a camaraderie and a rapport with us almost instantly.
You hold on to an upright, and you keep your eye on the direction that we're going in so you know when we're gonna hit.
Right.
And be prepared to get pitched forward.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so you just hold yourself and come back. We may fall over each other, you know, which is fine. If it's very windy, we'll make sure that my father and I are in the front of the basket with you guys behind us, so we tip over rather than us falling on you, so you guys fall on us. And you always want to face them when they fall on you. Much more fun to put your arms at.
We get in the fun to protect you.
Okay. We fall on top.
Right. You never know what might happen.
All right.
I think the idea of allowing us to help get the balloons up is just a great one.
Almost everyone kind of jumped in and wanted to get their hands on the balloon to see how it felt and how heavy it was and the weight in your hands. That was part of the fun.
That's going to send us pretty much due west. And what I'd like to do is come out here and climb up to about 500 feet and see if we can head right for the parador. And once we get over that, we should get some really pretty views. Whatever, you know, churches, buildings, whatever's there. Just climb out slow until you get that turn, and then as soon as we get a direction for the parador, we'll just hold it and stay together.
Thank you.
see all these towns from the air, unobstructed, you get a much better feeling for what the countryside looks like. And it's just a wonderful way to see a country.
What makes every day an adventure is that you don't know what you're going to see or who you're going to see doing it.
There's something about being with balloons. Just when you pull into the parking lot of a hotel and you've got the balloons with you, you just make a different impression on the people around you and you meet more people.
Traveling with a balloon group is a unique experience because it's as though you are royalty.
Traveling by balloon, I think, is a different dimension. I don't think there's anything to compare that. It's strictly something that you're allowed maybe once in a lifetime to have.
One day, we came down, and there were Spanish farmers who came to meet us. They wanted us to go back to their home and have breakfast with them. It was wonderful. We didn't know ahead of time we were going to meet these people who came up to us so warmly and greeted us like we had been gods who had flown out of the sky to them.
Didn't realize how large an impact we'd make everywhere we went. If we landed in a farmer's field, we always shared champagne with him. It was something they rarely experienced. And that made our celebration all the more wonderful.
Yay. Toast to a wonderful flight over Santa Fe, over this lovely country, and a safe landing here in the fields near Santa Fe.
Hey.
Thank you.
The flowers are so vivid. The architecture is so beautiful that wherever you would point your camera, you couldn't possibly miss having a great shot. As the balloon came down closer to the ground, those greens and shades of greens and brown all melded into fields of flowers, and the scents wafted to the balloon. We were struck at the wonderful sweetness in the air. And the balloon was suspended over the ground. The ground and the trees and the flowers and everything about you seems to be moving past you. But the balloon seems to stand still. We were invited to participate in the crushing of the grapes in the old fashioned, really, but it was fun for that reason. I mean, I laughed till I cried. What a delightful aspect of the balloon trip, to come to the beach. It was the cherry on the cake. We were very special tourists on this kind of trip. The world loves balloonists. But it was wonderful to kind of peek into someone else's life, as you do flying over a balloon. Whereas if you're in a car, you go past their house very quickly and you really don't take it in.
There was a priest up there who saw us, and he started to ring the bells. We thought it was a service going on, but it was for us.
See a little kid in the window?
David, these pictures are going to be outrageous.
One of those experiences that you only expect to get once in a lifetime.
We look back on those times of having traveled together as very special.